Hi, everyone. This is Mrs. Picaro, and I'm going to do an integrated science lesson with you today. So we're going to start by talking about the Statue of Liberty. So I'm going to give you a little background into the history of the Statue of Liberty. So the Statue of Liberty was an effort by the French and the United States government to commemorate the friendships between our two nations. It was designed and built by French sculptor Frédéric Auguste Bartholdi. He created this statue out of copper sheets. Interestingly enough, the structure that he built this on was designed by a man named Alexander Gustave Eiffel. And if you know anything, or maybe you've been to France and maybe you've seen the Eiffel Tower, that gentleman designed the Eiffel Tower. So he also helped with building this steel structure that Bartholdi put the copper sheets on. The statue was given to the United States and is erected on a small island in the upper New York Bay, near New York City. It was dedicated in 1886 by President Grover Cleveland, and this statue today serves as a symbol of freedom and democracy, and it welcomed millions of immigrants as they arrived to America via Ellis Island back in the early 1900s. So that's a little history lesson. But this got me thinking, copper does not look like how the Statue of Liberty looks right now. That picture was taken by me the last time I visited New York City and I went to the Statue of Liberty. When I think of copper, I think of a penny. Bright, shiny, copper colored, okay, on both sides. That's what I think of when I see a penny, okay? And this is made of copper, and the Statue of Liberty is made of copper. So it got me thinking. So then I did some more research, and I wanted to look at some, what did the Statue of Liberty look like when it was first erected? So I had to go and do some research. And I went to the Library of Congress and I found some really cool photos and some drawings of the Statue of Liberty. So this photo right here was taken after the head of the Statue of Liberty was constructed. And this, they put it in a park in Paris during the World Fair for people to look at. And they were still in the process of constructing the other parts of the Statue of Liberty. But this is a neat photo. However, it doesn't really tell me much about color because it's a black and white photo. So I will show you another photo that I found. This photo was taken in the sculptor's studio. And if you look at, these are all the gentlemen here that are helping to build the Statue of Liberty. So it took a lot of people, not just Bartholdi by himself. And if you notice in the background, you see this big, huge hand. And if you look closely at this primary resource, that she is holding the tablet, okay, in hand. So this is the part of the Statue of Liberty where she's holding the book. And this is her hand and her arm. So this, they would take this and attach it to the head like they did in the earlier photo. But again, this doesn't really tell me how the Statue of Liberty changed to this green color that we see today. So I got to searching some more and I found this artist drawing of the Statue of Liberty. And this is where, this is, she's erected on a pedestal in the upper New York Bay. And this is what it looks like at the time of her, that she was constructed. And if you'll notice in this picture, she's brown. I also found another photo or another drawing of the Statue of Liberty, and she's brown, just like this penny was. So that got me to thinking, well, how did the Statue of Liberty change? So that's what we're gonna do an investigation on. So I have several pennies. I found different types of pennies, like the shiny one, like I showed you at the beginning. Notice it's really shiny. It's what we call a new penny, okay? But I have other pennies that don't look exactly like that. So I have this penny. You'll notice it's duller than the original one. There's still some shiny parts to it. What made it change? Then I have this one. Here's another one. Again, a little dull, not that unshiny, okay? And then finally, I have this one. And notice, if you look at it, it's kind of green. You see right there? Just kind of like what the Statue of Liberty looks like. She's got that green on her. So something happened to the Statue of Liberty, just like something happened to this penny, to make it go from this to this. So we're gonna do a little investigation. Well, the Statue of Liberty is outside and she's surrounded by water. So definitely she gets rained on, right? So rain is liquid, and we're gonna do a little experiment to see if maybe something that's in that precipitation is caused the Statue of Liberty to change color. So our question for this investigation is, how did the Statue of Liberty change color? So you're going to plan your own investigation to determine what substances will make a penny change, okay? You're going to figure out and what might have caused that, the Statue of Liberty to change colors. And you have some choices about liquids that you can use. So you can use the juice from a lemon. You can use the juice from a lime. You can use some sparkling water or just some normal tap water. You can add salt to the water and make the water salty. You can use soda, any brand of soda, hot sauce if you have some of that. You can add some sugar to the water and make sugar water, or you can add some dish soap or liquid soap to water and make it soapy water. If you have baking soda, you can add that to your to some water, or even toothpaste if you think maybe that will change the penny. So on this side, tell me, you write what you need, then you choose one of these to test, and then how are you going to get these materials? So this is where you need to think. Do I need to ask a grown-up to help me if you're not sure where to get all these? The next thing you need to do is you need to come up with a procedure. How are you going to carry out your investigation? What are you going to do first? What are you going to do second? What are you going to do third? And there's some extra spaces here for you to add on if you need more than three steps. And that's okay if you do. But be sure that you are writing here in complete sentences, because as scientists, we want to be able to replicate an investigation. So if you're a teacher or you're a grown-up were to carry out your investigation, your procedure would be really important for someone else to replicate or repeat what you did in your investigation. So once you've gathered your materials, there's a couple things that you're going to need just for safety. And safety is very important when we're doing science, when we're being scientists. Also, make sure if you're doing this at home, you have a grown-up nearby. And it'd be great if this would be a great way to ask a grown-up to help you if you need it. All right, so once you got your material, you decide what you needed, you've asked a grown-up, you've figured out how you're going to get the material, and you've come up with your investigation, now it's time to carry it out. Like, you've got the steps, now you actually carry out the investigation. So before I carry out my investigation, I've got to put my goggles on and my gloves on. Okay, so I'm safe and I am ready to go. Yes, I might look a little silly right now, but that's okay. I am safe and I want you to be safe too. So please follow safety rules, okay? So I've got my two cups here and I've got my two pennies right here. I'm gonna take the penny and put it in the bottom of the cup right here, okay? And I'm gonna do the same thing for my second cup. So they're gonna be on the bottom of my cup and I'm gonna put the same amount of liquid in each cup. So it has something to do with rain, I think. Okay. And rain is water. So I got some tap water here. Okay. And I'm going to put a tablespoon of tap water. I'm going to start with a tablespoon and see if it completely covers my penny. If it doesn't, then I may add another one. So I'm gonna add that here. I'm gonna make sure that I get a complete, when I'm measuring, that the water comes up to the edge, okay? That measurement is very important when we're doing science. So if you look here, you'll see that the penny is completely covered by a tablespoon of water. So I know that amount is correct. So I'm gonna leave that there. Then I'm going to, my material that I'm gonna choose is lemon juice. Now you can squeeze a lemon and get from a real lemon, but I have a bottle of lemon juice that I'm gonna use. So it is the same thing. So I'm going to put a tablespoon of lemon juice on the other penny I don't have any liquid in, okay? And the reason I'm gonna use a tablespoon is I used a tablespoon of water. And in order for this to be a fair test, I have to have the same amount of liquid. So here we go. I'm gonna measure a tablespoon of lemon juice, okay? Here it is. Notice it's all the way to the top and it's filled my tablespoon. And I'm gonna carefully put that lemon juice on my penny. So here it is. Okay, you can't really see the penny because it is cloudy. But now what I gotta do is I've got to observe it. And in my experiment, I'm gonna observe each penny every 5 minutes, and I'm gonna write down how the pennies look. So if I go to the next page here, I'm gonna my prediction is that the lemon juice will change the penny. I think the water will make it maybe stay the same. I'm not sure. That's my prediction. That's what I gotta find out. So every 5 minutes, I'm gonna collect data. And that data, I'm gonna describe what happened, any kind of visible changes to the physical properties of the penny, meaning the color, maybe the shape, did it change its size, if there's noting. You could even measure the diameter of the penny if you think that there might be a change in size, can note if it's flexible or hard, and anything about your penny before you put it in a liquid. Describe what happens at each interval. So, you know, maybe nothing happens the first 5 minutes. Maybe it takes, you know, 20 minutes for me to see any changes. Okay, but I'm going to observe this for a total of 30 minutes and look at the pennies each 5 minutes until 30 minutes have passed. And then I'm going to note if there's any changes or not. Okay, so I'll see you in 30 minutes. Hey everybody, we're back. And I want to share with you what I found out. So I took some pictures of my pennies. On the right-hand side of the screen is the penny in the water. And on the left-hand side will be the penny in the lemon juice. Now, every 5 minutes, I snapped a photo, and then below the photo, I made note of any changes that I saw. So after 5 minutes, I noted that the penny in the water appeared to have no visible change, and the penny in the lemon juice had no visible change. Okay, so here's after 10 minutes. Again, there was no change in either penny. The one in the water didn't change, and the one in the lemon juice appeared to have no change. And here we are looking at the pennies again after 15 minutes, and there's no change. And then here's after 20 minutes. Again, I saw no visible change in either penny. Here's 25 minutes, and again, I noted no change in either penny. And here is after 30 minutes. Again, no visible change after 30 minutes. So all of this data that I collected can help me answer the following question, okay? Explain your results and how the results indicate a physical or chemical change. Well, for me, because I didn't observe either, I would say that the results were inconclusive. I can't determine if the color change on the Statue of Liberty is a chemical change or a physical change. So I got to thinking though, I could actually do another investigation. I could take the pennies out of the liquid and let them dry out in the sun and see what happens. And then maybe I can determine if it's a physical or chemical change based on the evidence I've gathered. So I don't have evidence to prove one way or the other. And in science, it works like that. So I thought the lemon juice would make some kind of change just by putting the penny in the lemon juice and letting it sit there for 30 minutes. But that didn't really give me enough information one way or the other. Right now, I don't know. And that's part of science. So sometimes you do an investigation and it leads to other questions, or you have to think of another way to do an investigation based on the evidence that you gathered. So that is science. And that's how it works sometimes. But maybe when you have a chance to do this investigation, you'll find out something that I didn't, and that's fine. So I hope that you enjoy this investigation. And now it is time to clean up, okay? You need to wash the utensils that you use, so like the tablespoon, the cups, okay? Once you finish washing those, take your gloves off. These can be thrown away, and wash your hands. And then finally, when you're finished with your goggles, you need to take them off and you need to disinfect them so you can use them the next time. Okay, have a great day and enjoy being a scientist.